So remember when you finish your morning coffee, that amazing last sip, and you sit down to get to that first meeting and everyone's around the table, your boss, your boss's boss, and about 20 minutes into it, you're like, oh shoot, I'm gonna go to the bathroom. Maybe I shouldn't have finished that coffee this morning. Today, I'm going to teach you about bladder irritants like coffee that can affect the way that your bladder reacts and makes you feel like you got to go sometimes. And for some people, these bladder irritants can be really strong and bothersome. And for others, it really doesn't matter. So we're going to get down and dirty with the science behind it and talk to you all about it. So I'm Dr. Malik. I'm a female pelvic medicine and reconstructive surgeon, and I'm here to teach you how to live your best life and improve your pelvic health. So let's go. I will wholeheartedly admit that I love coffee. I cannot go a day without at least one cup of coffee. I have two boys, I'm a full-time working mom, I'm a surgeon, and I love my coffee. But, you know, there's certainly times where I'll drink a coffee and I gotta go to the bathroom 5 times when normally I probably only had to go once. So why does that even happen? Well, in animal studies, they've looked at animals and they've looked at their chronic caffeine consumption, those who've taken caffeine or drank caffeine for a very long time in large amounts, and they found that it actually affects the way your bladder functions. It actually makes your bladder contract more often. And those bladder contractions actually make you feel the urge to go to the bathroom. And that's why after you drink coffee, sometimes you'll feel the urge more strongly. Also, caffeine is a diuretic. So when you drink a cup of coffee or any sort of caffeinated beverage, a soda, a tea, even some chocolate that has caffeine in it, you'll find that you're making more urine than you're actually putting in your body as far as fluids. So you're going to go to the bathroom more often. There's some data that shows that actually the caffeine itself makes our bladders more sensitive so that we actually feel full sooner than we actually normally would. So that may explain why some of you guys have that experience. So they did a study on healthy young adults, so between the ages of 18 to 45, and they basically had them all sign up, and for 5 days they were in a pre-exposure phase, which means that they couldn't drink any caffeine. After 5 days, they were randomized, meaning half of them, about 28, got a caffeinated beverage that was measured out for a certain amount of caffeine, which was actually 450 milligrams of caffeine. And then the other group was given the same amount of coffee, but it was a decaf amount. So it was about 12 or 15 grams of coffee. And they measured the caffeine to be 450 milligrams. What exactly does that even mean? So that is like the equivalent of one venti Starbucks cup, 2.5 large McDonald's coffees, 1.5 Dunkin' Donuts coffees, and for those in Canada, 1.5 Tim Hortons coffees. And you know why I know about Tim Hortons? I'm from Buffalo, New York, which is basically like Canada, and I grew up drinking Tim Hortons, and it's amazing. So if you haven't had it, make sure you try it when you go to Canada or if you ever come to Buffalo. Also asked the participants how much they measured how much coffee or caffeine intake they had daily before the study, and so they grouped them as high-frequency users, or they drank a lot of caffeine all the time, or low-frequency users. They drank a little coffee all the time. And so what they found was those who drank a lot of coffee, when they went to decaf, their symptoms, their urinary urgency and frequency symptoms went down. High users before the study and then began drinking were in the caffeinated groups, still had an increase in their urgency and frequency of urination. And those who were in the low frequency group, when they got exposed to caffeine, they had way worse urgency and frequency. And then when that low group stayed low, again, they had no change in their symptoms. So what does this tell us? Well, caffeine does correlate with symptoms of urgency and frequency. If you're a high user already, you might have developed some tolerance to it. But if you're regularly a low user and you go out and you're like, hey, I want a venti frappuccino from Starbucks, you're probably going to have to go to the bathroom a little more than usual. Bottom line is, if you're drinking coffee, it might make you go a lot, especially if you are drinking a lot of it. And if you find that it's bothering you that you're going to the bathroom a lot, well, then cut back on your caffeine. So other things I tell my patients is, if you are drinking coffee and you know it makes it worse, but you don't really care, you can try not to drink it before you go on a plane or before you go to the movies, so that maybe you won't have problems moving forward. So that's our first bladder irritant. Let's move on to our next one. So number 2 bladder irritant is alcohol. Alcohol, when you drink it, it gets metabolized in your body to a metabolite called acetaldehyde. And acetaldehyde actually is a bladder irritant. It goes into our bloodstream and into our urine, and it can affect our bladder that way and make it increase the ability to contract. Alcohol is actually a diuretic. Similar to caffeine, it's going to make you make more urine than you actually produce. So when you drink, you might notice that people are going to the bathroom a little more often when they're at the brewery or when they're having their glass of wine with dinner. Alcohol also is a bladder irritant and makes your bladder contract more strongly. And so it also increases that urge feeling like you gotta go, gotta go. And so for some people, this is worse than others. They've shown though that there is some benefit to moderate alcohol intake. So what's moderate alcohol intake? That's 1 5-ounce glass of wine, a 12-ounce glass of beer, and a 1.5-ounce shot of 80-proof alcohol. So moderate drinking includes one drink per day for women or 2 drinks per day for men. So the data here is controversial. For some people, alcohol has not panned out to be a bladder irritant. Definitely in high uses, alcohol is a big no. Alcohol can also be a bladder irritant. It can also make you go a lot. So if you're bothered by it, watch what you're drinking. Maybe cut back on that drinking a little bit. Another bladder irritant is actually carbonated beverages. And why? Because they have preservatives like citric acid and ascorbic acid, which increases the ability of your bladder to contract. So for some people, you might be sensitive to carbonated beverages because of those preservatives. Carbonated beverages can contain caffeine, which we talked about earlier, and artificial sweeteners, which are our next bladder irritants. Artificial sweeteners like aspartame or saccharin, these things are also considered bladder irritants and can make the bladder contract more. So other bladder irritants, there's really very little data on the rest of these. And so you guys have to pay attention and see how your bladder reacts when you eat or drink some of these things. So they can include spicy foods or acidic foods like grapefruit. So what you can do is just pay attention and try to limit them in your diet as needed. I would say take one away at a time and see if it helps. If it doesn't, put it back in your diet. If you want, I've also made a link down below where you can download a full list of bladder irritants that you can keep for yourself for your reference. So go on and click on that. So after experimenting with all these bladder irritants, are you still having problems? Well, make sure you go see your doctor or your local urologist so we can help you out. Take care of yourself because you're worth it. And don't forget to click on the link down below if you want a full list of bladder irritants, and subscribe to my channel if you like what you see. Next week, we'll be talking about overactive bladder and what you can do to help it. So make sure you check it out.